Hi, I'm Masha, and I manage NVIDIA Kaolin Library, which has many useful functions for 3D deep learning and a PyTorch API. Today, let's talk about meshes. When working on 3D and deep learning, it's hard to avoid polygonal surface meshes in your pipeline. For example, you might use deep learning to modify an input mesh, or generate a new one, or train on large datasets of 3D shapes like ShapeNet or Optiverse. Kaolin Library has a new Surface Mesh class that makes dealing with meshes and their PyTorch tensor attributes easier. Let's dive right in. On the surface, a surface mesh is simple. Common 3D file formats can be read into tensors representing vertices, or their positions in space, and faces, which are indices into the vertex tensor. For example, faces of a quad mesh have 4 vertices, and faces of a triangle mesh have 3. Let's go ahead and load this armchair with Kaolin. Kaolin can load USD, gltf, and OBJ formats. How do we know what just loaded? Let's simply print this mesh. By default, we only load the bare bones geometry. We'll come to normals and other attributes in a moment. For now, we loaded vertices and faces. We can clearly see the size of each PyTorch tensor, its type, as well as the device where it is located. But what if your mesh has both triangles and quads? You can no longer neatly represent faces as a two-dimensional index tensor. To read any mesh in Kaolin as a triangular mesh, simply specify triangulate equals true. You will now see that all the faces are triangular and they're twice as many. Observe that some attributes are also listed as autocomputable. Recall that the faces tensor contains indices into the vertex array. What if for some building block of your code you actually need 3D vertex locations of every face stored in a separate array? It's easy enough to index, but caching and bookkeeping can get annoying. Surface Mesh allows you to compute such indexed attributes automatically on axis. For example, let's try simply accessing mesh face vertices. We see that now this value is available. For every vertex of every face, we have XYZ vertex location in 3D. We can also compute face normals simply from vertex locations. You see that the face normals value is now set. But of course, if your mesh already comes with normals, it's much better to load that. Now we have a lot more tensors to work with. You have the normals array, which is not associated to vertices or faces in any way. But face normals index now provides an index into the normals array for every vertex of every face. Similarly, for UVs and face UVs index, we're also provide materials. Now let's cover common mesh manipulations that might come up in deep learning. I can convert my mesh to a batch representation and print it. Now you will see for all of the attributes except for faces, we added a batch dimension. We're also able to concatenate mesh as a fixed topology. We can also convert our mesh to another device, and it can be some or all attributes. For example, let's try just converting the vertices. You will see that now the device of only the vertex attributes is set to CUDA. Now, if we run this for all of the attributes, you will see that all of the attributes are now on the first device. You can also say mesh 2, for example, your primary GPU. For more useful things that the Surface Mesh can do for you, I encourage you to check out our detailed documentation as well as a notebook under our GitHub, Kaolin Examples Tutorial Working with Meshes. It covers some additional features of Surface Mesh, for example, gradient flow through autocomputable attributes. We hope this helps you in your deep learning workflows. Subscribe to our GitHub for updates on upcoming releases.